You're listening to Be Happy. Be inspired by great interviews, great music, and news of inspirational events.
Well, Christmas is fast approaching. In fact, as I'm sat here today, I think we're, what, 7 days away? Mm-hmm. Or 8 days away from Christmas, whatever. And I'm over in Bordwina, Doncaster. And you might be thinking about making a change in 2019. Well, I'm sat with Olga. Olga is a life coach and helps people make the change. Olga, welcome to Be Happy, Be Inspired. How did you get involved in life coaching?
Thank you, Steve. It's a pleasure to be here. Well, as you just mentioned, change in life. For me, it was a huge change when I came to UK in 2009. I realized that I can't continue with my counseling as I was trained in Latvia simply because I did not speak any English. So you can't life coach any other or do counseling when you don't put two words together, right? So I realized I need to change something in my life, and off I went and I built a business. So as a part educating myself within business industry, I was going to seminars and events where actually I realized that there's a big thing going on now about life coaching, which is, as many people will think, what is life coaching? Is it something like a counseling? Is it something like a therapy? And I would say, yes, it's very similar, but it's deeper. It's where big changes are happening and actually life getting changed, rather one particular issue. And then I realized that I was happy with my counseling, but life coaching would be something like next level. So this is how I got into that. It was purely through building my business, going to seminars, events, learning about new opportunities. And I realized I can do more for other people rather than just counseling, because I finally, back then, spoke English.
Well, that's a change in itself, isn't it? Yeah. Just taking the initiative to go and learn the language. That's a great challenge.
Absolutely. It was very challenging because, as you can imagine, if now you go to Russia and you have to build a business, where do you start?
Yes, yeah. You know, it's a challenge for me, and I am English, and I, you know, people say to me, can you really speak it, Steve? But Olga, life coaching is an interesting term. Do you think, I mean, some people say to me, because we work in the same industry and things like that, and some people say to me, oh, Steve, it's that touchy-feely stuff.
Well, yes, as you can see on my desk, there's a tissue box.
Yes.
It is, of course, because we always tap into something very deep, into something forgotten, into something that happened to you very often in your childhood, early days of your school, probably maybe something that happened in university. And therefore, we all have some stories in our heads, and people call them limiting beliefs. So, of course, those stories or limiting beliefs, they are controlling us. Mm. Never mind where it is relationship, maybe it is your work, or maybe it is even relationship with your money. But whatever story you have in your head, that is something what is on the way for you to be happy and successful in every area of your life. So yes, it is emotional. Yes, it is touchy. Yes, it is about feelings. But without them, we wouldn't be human beings.
But it's also challenging, isn't it? You know, because you know, there's a great question that I think the question is, if you had to earn a living one day for the rest of your life, what would you choose to do? That's not touchy-feely. That's quite thought-provoking.
It is. Yes, yeah. I know what you mean. Yes.
Yeah.
Very often I actually ask my question this, my clients this question: what would you do if tomorrow would be your last day? Because very often people have great plans. In my 10 years, I'll do that. In my 5-year plan, I'll do that. And I always ask, what would you do if tomorrow is your last day of your life?
Yeah.
And this one, people actually say, you know what? I'll spend time with my family.
Mm.
I'll go visit my mom.
Yeah.
I'll go and I spend time with my daughter, whom I haven't seen for many years. And there's so many different answers, but I always say, as long as you're happy internally, outside things, they'll always come. Material things, they will always come, but you have to be happy from inside, deep in your heart. And therefore, asking yourself this question, what would you do if tomorrow your last day, if next year is the last year of your life, is very, very important, because then the very deep answers will come out. Because it's always easy to say a logical answer when it comes to what's your 5-year plan.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, buy a house and do that and buy a car. Yes, it's logical. But it's not something that will make you happy.
No,
it's not.
No. And also, you know, when you bring this into business as well, we've just been talking over a coffee before we sat down and to record this. Even in business, you know, life affects business, doesn't it?
Absolutely, yes. I really wonder when people want to start building businesses and they think, oh, I've got this really awesome talent, or I'm really, really good at doing this. And I say, well, it's not enough. You might be really talented, really good at something what you do, but where's your confidence? How good are you with time management? So many people, they struggle with their own finances and personal life. And guess what will happen with your business? That's the situation.
Yeah.
Exactly. If you don't pay your bills in life, you're not going to pay them in a business. And therefore, so many businesses fail because the personal habits are not at that level at what they should be. Mm-hmm. And therefore, I always say business coaching is definitely going hand in hand with life coaching. Definitely. And it always should go, because whatever personality you are, you'll be that personality in your business. And they can kill your business big time.
Yeah. So there's some challenges all the way around. You know, and I think we should say as well, going into 2019, we're going to do some regular pieces together and share some things.
Absolutely. Let's make the world better.
Yeah, let's make the world better. So Olly, if people want to get in touch with you, how can they do that?
Well, they definitely can follow the link.
Yes.
And also they can follow the website, which is kickstarter. Yes, yeah, so newlifekickstart.com.
Brilliant. Well, look, thanks for taking time out today, and wish you well for 2019. Look forward to talking to you some more.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure seeing you today. It was a pleasure to actually doing this podcast. Thank you so much, and wish you all the best in 2019.
Thank you.
Be Happy, Be Inspired is a weekly podcast. For more information about Steve Twynham and how to join the growing number of listeners, visit stevetwynham.com. Be Happy, Be Inspired is produced and presented by Steve Twynham. Copyright applies.